seven or nine questions right now. So right now there are seven that as a start, I think that it would be great to work with seven of that are already involved. The objective of my brother's keeper is really to allow for everybody in the process to count everybody nationally to reach their potential life. We want to also come off the chance, we want to provide opportunities, we want to make sure governments are efficient and don't look around and don't look over our young people.
Well, I think we look at some of the existing money that we spend now on youth bureau services, on working with various correction departments, and try to determine how much of the outreach money we have that can be channeled this area, because this does. And it's effective. It has an education component to it, it has a crime prevention component to it, it has a job component to it, and there are pots of money in the county government presently allocated for that purpose that, if properly repurposed, can help advance this program. All I can tell you is that when I ran for state senate last year, I debated my Republican challenger 13 times. I didn't turn down any debates, and I've done that every time I ran for state senate when I was the incumbent. Earlier this year, Ken Jenkins and I debated 9 times as candidates for Democratic nomination. So I've always been able to debate. I've been able to debate in any forum. So the one debate forum that we have is the Business Council of Westchester. And I'd like to see it be much more diverse. But all I can do is come prepared to discuss the issues and priorities. And I would hope that the county executive would understand this is what democracy is, to be open to try to discuss these things face to face, side by side.
What do you think is the big topic?
Well, I think we're going to talk about the fiscal status of the county and the projections of the future. I've been critical of the fact that I don't have my understanding and analysis of what I think is wrong and what I think will change. I've been critical of what I think is just a closed, non-transparent government where you're not working with the Board of Legislature, you're not working with the municipal governments in an open way. I tend to make those criticisms in a positive way. I've been subject, not just in this election, but in almost every election, to a positive drumbeat of negativity. And that negativity doesn't help you judge who the better candidate is. It basically tries to get in the mud. So I'm going to try to stay on a higher plane, debate with intelligence and energy and vigor. Yeah, I think every time. Last year, I'll use this as an example. I was an incumbent senator. I could have said I'm only going to limit myself to 3 debates or something like that, judge me on my record, but I didn't do that. We had League of Women Voters debates in Harrison and Bedford and Rye and almost every community. We had a debate in Purchase. We had a debate on WVOX radio. In almost every venue that was offered, I had a shirt for my challenger. Obviously, wanted the opportunity to be side by side, so we both debated. And I think it should be the standard procedure, not the exceptional procedure. And every time the candidate's running for office, they should be willing to take on as many plausible debates as necessary to structure. And the League of Women Voters have had historic debates in this county. We've trusted them for years to do these things. I would hope that your media outlets would have debates so that we'd be seen in a televised format. And the Daily Newspaper would be the same thing as well. All those things could help. I've already started the process of creating new people. There's nothing new with me. I've been in public office previously, and I think it starts with understanding where we are physically, where we have to really strengthen where we are. It also has to do with programs that I've been very clear about. I would not move forward on the airport, Sullivan, Westchester County Airport, expansion of the airport. I oppose that. I've been very clear that I think that there's some proactive things we need to do in the environment that we're not doing. And I think it's laying out a positive argument that contrasts, not just an attack on the other person, but a discussion of those
positions.
The only people that are going to know are the voters, but I'm very competitive, I'm working hard every day. And what I hear from people is that I'm breaking through.
I'm breaking through.
Oh, Bob, how are you?